Hey, how you guys doing? It is your girl Tasha, and we are here to talk semifinal weeks in X Factor USA. I was a little nervous coming into this week because I just don't know what's going to go down. We have our top four. They're performing twice. Everybody belongs in the top four that's there right now, and they did good. Tonight was a great performance night. So let's go ahead and get into it. First up, we're going to be doing two rounds. Round one, the contestants get to choose the song that they want to sing for us. So up first is Tate Stevens, and he gives us a song called Bonfire, and he did his thing. I have to give it to him, you know. I don't prefer country music, so I don't prefer Tate Stevens. I'm not checking for him, but vocally, he did really good, and he sounded nice. Brittany was like, hell no, that wasn't your best. I mean, because she didn't say it like that, but basically, that's what she was saying. She was like, that wasn't your best. I didn't like it. I mean, she just came out the gate and moved it on, all right? Demi Lovato kind of disagreed finally with the queen, because you know she always agrees with the queen, but she had to go sideways and was like, I don't know what you're talking about, Brittany. That was pretty dope. And then of course Simon said that it was one of his favorite performances from Tate Stevens, and of course LA, being his mentor, liked him and just thinks that he's the greatest thing in the world. Okay, you guys let me know what you thought about Tate Stevens. He's competition. I will have to say that he is competition. I just don't prefer him. Next up was Carly Rose, and she did Your Song by Elton John. This was not my favorite performance from her, but Carly Rose still sings you down. I mean, some of the inflections that she was giving, some of those runs, she's good. They're 13 years old. Come on now, Carly. You are freaking amazing, all right? LA said that he liked it. Demi Lovato was straight up honest, and she was like, look, it's predictable. You always come out here and do these slow songs, these like old songs or whatnot. But she said this was one of my favorite performances from you because she sounded really good. And then Simon said it was a beautiful version of a fabulous song, all right? It wasn't her best, though. So me and Simon were seeing eye to eye on that one. Emblem 3 came out next with Baby I Love Your Way, and all of the judges like really, really liked it. Like, they were like, LA was like, this is $5 million worth. I see you as stars. Demi was like, oh, you guys have moved to another level. You're no longer just some simple punk boy band. And Brittany, no, wait a minute, hold on. Brittany said that. Demi was like, you know, she's feeling them, she's loving them, and she's learning to really respect them and everything. And Simon, of course, you know, he's their mentor, so he loved it. I didn't really care for it that much. Yes, I know, I swooned for Emblem 3, but I just wasn't feeling a performance like that. Was it really that good? Maybe I was missing something. I don't know. Fifth Harmony came out last on this round. They did Anything Can Happen, and this was a great vocal and a very, very, very cute staging from them. They dressed up like princesses. They had like a little tea party or whatever it was. It was kind of like Disney princesses meet Alice in Wonderland and all this stuff. They had on their baby doll dresses and their rhinestones and their Cuban zirconias, and they was just fierce, girl. They was giving it to us, all right? I loved it. They did a little bit of acting. They worked the stage, so Demi was happy. LA said that it was one of the best performances that they've done all season, so it was really good. I liked it, you know what I'm saying? Go ahead, girls. You do your thing. So round one is almost a tie between Tate Stevens, Carly Rose, and Fifth Harmony, with Emblem 3, in my opinion, coming in last, all right? Let's move on to round two. Round two, the contestants and their mentors had to choose a song that's going to place them into next week's finals, all right? So, Tate Stevens comes out, he does this song called Fall, and this is my thought on Tate Stevens this whole season, I guess. It was really nice. He did good. We're used to hearing this from Tate. I like all season how they have really been setting him up as a star. What you've been seeing on the X Factor stage with Tate Stevens is what you're going to see when he's on the CMAs, when he goes out on tour, when he's at the American Music Awards, the Billboard Awards, whatever, the Grammys. When you see Tate Stevens perform live somewhere, everything that you've been getting on the X Factor stage is what he's going to do. They have set him up really, really good. They have set him up as a star. So I'm starting to also understand why y'all like him so much. You know what I'm saying? So if Tate is your thing, keep voting for him. He'll be in the finals next week. So I'm not even worried about him. Carly Rose came out next with Imagine. And Carly just sings, okay? She really sang that song. She started out on the piano, you know, tinkering on the piano. I thought she was really going to give me like some Alicia Keys, Vanessa Carlton type kind of stuff. But, you know, she did her thing on the piano. Then she got up and she kind of sang the song. Like, she was doing the most with the song, I will have to say that. But it was still good. I liked it, you know. She was kind of taking a little different because... Okay, Demi is right. Carly is predictable. You know what I'm saying? So I don't know what kind of album Carly is going to make. She's 13, but she kind of gives me like this old soul type, Adele-ish almost feeling. So that's why I'm saying I'm going to buy her album. But honestly and truly, I don't want to hear kids bop when I buy her album. So I don't know if she's going to cater towards 13-year-olds or if she's going to cater to people like more my age. I ain't telling y'all my age. Stop being nosy. All right. Next up, Emblem 3 came out and they did Hey Jude. And they lost me in round one. But honey, they brought me back with round two. I loved this performance. It was really, really dope. I think it was different for them. I loved it. It was really, really good. Some of the judges, you know, they were up and down with it and whatnot. But I really, really loved it. Wes and Keaton did their thing. I'm so glad they didn't really let Drew do that much singing this week. Because, good girl. But I'm just saying, it was really, really good. I love this performance from them. Emblem 3, they just need some polish. They need, you know, some A&R direction going with them. They're going to be super dope, whether they win or not, you know. I don't think they're going to win. I will say that. They're not going to win. I actually think they're going home tomorrow. But Emblem 3 did their thing tonight, and I really like where they've come. I hope they gain some confidence within themselves to continue to go forward and push themselves. I don't no longer see them as slackers, okay, that much. But anyway, Fifth Harmony came out last, and boom! They did Impossible. Now, you guys know that through my recaps, I've been saying that I haven't had that same feeling with Fifth Harmony like I got when they were at the judges' houses and they sang Impossible for Simon. But tonight, they pulled it back out. They changed it up. They did a little Espanol up in there and everything. Lauren did her thing. Camila, oh my God, they freaking carried this song. Shout outs again to Normani because Normani stepping up with the vocals. I still think she's going to be the first girl to be replaced in the group after the X Factor because she's the weakest link. But I'm trying to tell you, Camila and Lauren can go solo. They really can go solo. They carried that song. It was wonderful. The judges were kind of going tit for tat because LA was like, this was a bad song choice. And I didn't totally understand where he was coming from. This was the perfect song choice because I think all season we have been wanting to hear what we first heard when we first saw Fifth Harmony, and we were kind of like, is this going to work? And then when they did Impossible, we were like, dope, this is going to work. So I thought it was awesome to bring back Impossible, change it up with some, you know, put some little Spanish twang into it. It was amazing and it was awesome. I don't know what LA was talking about on that. But anyway, second round, now here I'm gonna have to tie first place between Emblem 3 and Fifth Harmony because those and Carly Rose. So I guess now I'm gonna put Tate Stevens down in the bottom for round two. Yeah, so that's how it goes for me. You guys, what is going to happen tomorrow? One person or one group is going home on tomorrow. The three will move on next week to the finals. I do think that Emblem 3 is going to get the boot. Yeah, I don't know. America, it's up to you to decide. You know what I'm saying? So whatever we decide is what goes down on tomorrow. I'm more excited to see Bruno Mars. I hope that he does my song Locked Out of Heaven. I really like that song. And yeah, so you guys tune in tomorrow. We'll talk about the results. And oh my gosh, I'm just getting nervous. X Factor USA Season 2, you've been pretty good. You've been pretty good. You guys stepped it up in some areas. Congratulations to you. I'm rocking out with you guys for Season 3. Auditions start now. Yes, you can go online tonight, the X Factor USA, and audition. If you think you got the X Factor and you can take on Season 3, do that. There's a few cities that they're going to. They're going to be in New Orleans. They're going to be, I don't know, girl. That's all I saw. And that's all I can remember is New Orleans. Anyway, Just go to the website, girl. You can catch up all that, okay? All right, you guys leave your comments below. Let me know what you thought about tonight. Who do you think is going home tomorrow? And who do you think is going to be making it into the finals? That's kind of like the same question in one, but daggone it. However it processes for you, you go ahead and answer that below. I love you guys. God loves you. Jesus can save. Make sure you follow me on Twitter. I will talk to you guys tomorrow. Bye.